anything you do with women, their moral character is attacked. Whether it's a divorce petition, whether it's a maintenance petition, whether it is rape case or a dowry death case, we tend to doubt a woman's moral character. And we always attack that. And that's become so universal, whatever else she may be or she may not be, this becomes the first thing to tarnish her. Unfortunately, the whole trial procedure is loaded against women. Still, there are biases that prevail both in the minds of the judges and of the defense lawyers. They call it a procedure breaking the witness. In this procedure, they ask such humiliating questions. They ask irrelevant questions to confuse the victim about her morality, about various other conduct of hers, which is not linked to this at all. But it's raised because the judges allow it. They don't stop the prosecutor from asking this question. And the victim feels very lost in this entire thing. If you see this very high-profile case of rape by the Bishop Franco Mulakal, and a woman who has filed a complaint is a 45-year-old nun. Immediately after the complaint was filed, she first put out a story that because some of the favors that she asked were not conceded to, she has manipulated and filed this complaint. Then there's another story that she was having an affair with a rickshaw driver. Then there is another story that she had sex with her relative. And this sitting MLA called her a prostitute. Now, this is what a victim has to go through if she comes out to file a case. Fortunately for this nun, there is a lot of support from various citizen organizations. But in an ordinary case, this is sufficient to break her confidence in the trial. She is extremely scared when she goes to court. So unless we monitor the system, it will go on functioning like this. There has to be a very strong mechanism to follow what exactly transpires in court to get conviction. And we don't have that. We have never focused on it. We are not focusing on simple measures to protect the victim from the FIR stage to the trial stage and thereafter.